So hello everyone, my name is Mark and welcome to a new video on my channel. In this video I'm gonna show you the best way to play with Manchester City. I'm gonna show you the tactics, the formation, the lineup and the instructions. And as you can see here, I play against someone who was playing with Juventus, in my opinion the best team in the game at the moment. And I crushed him with 7-0. 7-0 in Division 3, so it was really good for me. I'm gonna show you in this video how I did that. So if you're new to my channel, make sure you will subscribe to it, so I want to reach the 10k subs. Of course, it would be lovely if we do that before FIFA 20 is coming out, so let's go for that. If you liked the video, please leave a like for me underneath it. It's really useful for me as well. And if you have to say something or want to ask me something, drop it in the comment sections below. So I'm gonna start with the lineup. You already see it, of course. Edison is the goalkeeper. We have Walker at the right side. Otamendi and Laporte are the defenders. Laporte gets a really nice upgrade. I remember he was 84 rated at the beginning of the game. He is 86 rated and he becomes a really good defender in this game for me. So it's really nice to play with Manchester City, because before the central defenders weren't that good. Otamendi is okay, but Laporte with this upgrade, really, really useful. Mendy, left defender, of course. Then we have Fernandinho and De Bruyne as the central defensive midfielder. Some people will say De Bruyne isn't really good at the place, but for me it works really well. The defensive, he's good enough. With high work rates, he is almost everywhere on the pitch at the right moment. At the defense and also at the attack, as you can see in some examples I'm going to show you. Here you can see De Bruyne and Fernandinho are really good at combinations with each other, playing the ball. And yeah, with all these combinations you can create some good goals. Also the strikers, Aguero, almost always play the ball. You can always play the ball to Aguero most times. And with De Bruyne, with the high attacking work rates, you can choose to play the ball back or to the side to Sané, Sterling, and score your goals, as you can see in the examples. At the right we have Sterling, really fast player, of course, good player. Same for Sané, really fast, good player. We have Jesus and Aguero as the strikers. So then we're going to the tactics. Defensive style, pressure on every touch. We have a width of 5 bars because it's already a really wide formation. You don't have to defend really wide as well. It's not needed. 5 is just good. Depth, 4 bars is enough. Then offensive style, balanced, because for me it's a really good balance between possession style when it's needed and counter-attack style with fast build-up, ball playing when you have the opportunity. When you get the ball from your opponent and there is space for a counter attack, your players will recognize that and go for it as well. So as you can see here, Sterling and Sané are really wide, with the 8 bar width in the example I'm gonna show you here. Sané and Sterling really wide. You have a lot of space on the field to pass the ball. Players can dive into the gaps, run into the gaps they are, and you can use that to create your chances, as you can see in the example. De Bruyne from the defense to the attack here, really, really wonderful player to have in this formation. He's, I think, the best player for this formation as the defensive midfielder there. Then we have players in the box. It's 5 bars. We have corner kicks, free kicks, 2 bars for Manchester City. Why? They don't have that much players there are good at handling. Not much tall players, just only a few. Laporte, I scored a goal. I didn't show you for an example, but I scored a goal from a corner with him and almost another one, but that one get blocked by a defender. So Laporte is really good with corner kicks, but almost all other players aren't, so that's why I don't want them all in the box with these situations. Then we're going to the instructions. Walker, stay back while attacking. Same for Mendy. I want all my defenders at the back. I don't want to be weak at defense because my play style is trying to not get a goal against, and when there is an opportunity, score your own goals. That's why all defenders are stay back while attacking. When there is some space for the left or the right defender, you can always choose by yourself to let them run forward by pressing the button. Then we're going to Fernandinho and De Bruyne, both good passing lanes, stay back while attacking, and cover center. As you see here for De Bruyne, good passing lane, stay back while attacking, and cover center. Because of the work rate, this works really well for Manchester City. Fernandinho, with his work rates, high defensive, medium attacking, he will always stay a bit more at the back. De Bruyne, with high attacking work rates, makes some lovely runs forward, and you can have great combinations with them. Fernandinho is there to recover the ball when you lose it, and De Bruyne is more attacking, more the playmaker of this formation. As you can see here in the example as well, Fernandinho stays back, De Bruyne gets forward, and you create your chances and sometimes scoring some goals. Then we have Sterling and Sané, both the same. Come back on defense, stay wide, get in behind, and get into the box for the cross. As you can see here for Sané, the same. Come back on defense, stay wide, get in behind, and get into the box for the cross. As you can see here, Sané and Sterling are really wide. Then when you are attacking, they are getting to the box to be an extra option for you to pass the ball to and score your goals. And as you can see, Sterling and Sané always running deep when there is some space. You can pass the ball to them. They are making so much meters and creating so much space for themselves and for the other players, especially for De Bruyne. And yeah, it's always nice to have some space so you can pass the ball around really good and score the goals, of course. Then we're going to Aguero. Aguero is just default. He is a little bit like the target man of this formation. He is almost, with the default instructions, almost always playable. You can almost always play the ball to him and make combinations between Jesus or Sané or De Bruyne. You can almost play the ball to Aguero all the time. Then we have Gabriel Jesus. Only thing for him is getting behind. Yes, not that much space, but he's fast enough for me with this. He's making some lovely runs, as you can see in the example. Aguero is a target man. You play the ball to him. Jesus is getting deep and scoring goals. So that's it. I also scored a great free kick. That's always a good way to do that. This is the end of the video. I hope you liked it. If you did and you didn't like the video yet, make sure you do that. It will help me a lot. If you have to say something or want to ask me something, drop it in the comment sections below. And if you're new to my channel and didn't subscribe yet, make sure you do that as well. Really have a really nice day. Bye bye.